What is up, beautiful people of YouTube? My name is Yuritastic with another video in the LSPDFR tutorial guide. Today's video is going to be how to store plugins the suit LSPDFR. So the first video I've made is how to install the mod in general, the LSPDFR mod, how to install Rage plugin hook, which is kind of like the main thing, but it's kind of like having a chicken. You know, you're about to roast a chicken, you know, you could put it in the oven, take it out, you'll still have a roasted chicken, but you need some spices to make it a little better. And that's exactly what this is, to make the analogy work. So again, these plugins help you, you know, you can think of any plugin possible that has to do with policing, and somebody out there has made it pretty much. So you go to the same website, which is lcpdfr.com, or you can just Google LSPDFR. Then after that, what you want to go is to the mods, click on LSPDFR, and again, for the sake of this tutorial, I'm just be showing you something random. Sorry, click on downloads, and then go to scripts and plugins, okay? So once again, for the sake of this mod, I'll just be showing you something random. If you are new to it, this is pretty much the plugins like they have, like, you know, you can have a bait car plugin, you can have a taco highway callouts where, you know, highway related callouts will happen, spike strips plugin where you can deploy spike strips. So that's what plugins are pretty much. So let's just go here for the sake of this tutorial. Let's just put most downloaded, for example, and we'll click a popular one like Traffic Policer, okay? Traffic Policer is something I use, which is you can do a breathalyzer, speed check, the door locks when you walk away from the car, drugalyzer, etc., so on and so forth. All right, so here we are. You just click on it, download it, download the plugin that you want, and of course agree all this stuff. You might want to download the latest version, that always helps. All right, there it is, it's downloaded. So what you need to do is, as always, extract it. Most of them are gonna come compressed, so extract the file here. You know, I usually have, just to show you what I mean, let me drag it over in this screen. If you're planning on installing a lot of plugins, what would be smart is kind of have like a folder where you click and, you know, you have all the plugins that are installed, blah, blah, blah. That's one thing I usually do. So here's a file, it's unzipped. So some plugins are gonna be a little different, but about 90% of them are gonna be the same way that I'm showing you right now. So you click on the plugin file that you opened, and if you have Windows 10 or Windows 7 or 8, click in the place where you have your GTA 5 and LSPDFR installed, okay? Generally, the people that make these plugins make it easier for you to go step by step. So they're telling you right here, without even any notes, go to Grand Theft Auto folder, we're here. Then they're telling you to drop these two without any README files, that's what they're saying, drop these two in the directory folder. So we already have them dropped, so you just click and drag, okay? It's gonna tell me replace them, I already have them, I'm not gonna do it, okay? And then once you installed LSPDFR correctly, you should have a plugin folder and a LSPDFR folder. This is where you can either click and drag these as well. You can click and drag them, of course I have them, click and drag these inside as well, and that will go respectfully in their own folder. So if we click, we click the LSPDFR, we click here, we see police scanner, this is like where the police scanners for that plugin works. And if we click on plugins here, LSPDFR. If you successfully dragged it into the right folders, you should have Traffic Policer right here. So Traffic Policer, same tool here, and I got the same tool here. So that's how simply you install LSPDFR plugins, okay? As you can see, all of these you see are plugins. Rest Manager, Assorted Callouts, so on and so forth. So sometimes another step that you have to take is you have to go, let me close it out so I can show you. Once you try to launch Rage Hook plugins, that's where everything kind of goes. Before it goes on to the next screen, click on that settings wheel fast, this one right here. I couldn't do it that fast, maybe I'll pause it and show you. That one right there, okay? Click on that one right there, you come to plugins, and you make sure the plugin you just installed is checked over here. So Traffic Policer plugin, there it is. Because we just installed it, it is currently unchecked. So you check that plugin and now it will be loaded. So if you plan on playing a game, you can press save and launch. I'm not planning on playing a game, so I'm just gonna leave it as it is. But that's the last step. So let's recap. As always, you go here, pick the plugin that you want, download it. Once you download it, extract it. Usually, some of them have a README file, but most of them won't. But just assume that where the developer has put the Grand Theft Auto folder, they want you to go step by step. So Grand Theft Auto, drop this in the main directory if it has no folder, and grab these two and drop them in the main directory. You can actually just click and drag all of them if you want, and that would just save you some time. But yeah, if you don't have the plugins and the LSPDFR folder in your main directory, you're gonna have to reinstall LSPDFR because you did something wrong. So with that being said, subscribe to this channel, guys, because I plan on doing more LSPDFR tutorials and help guide to help you guys get going with that most amazing GTA 5 mod out there. It's really, really is a lot of fun. And please do consider subscribing to this channel for support. If you have any questions for me, ask them in the comment section below. Go ahead and hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you for watching. I am out.